Hello, my name is Aylin Puturlev and I represent Bulgaria. My question is about globalization, since this is one of the main values of the European Union. I suppose that everyone here has a different interpretation of the word. And my question is, have you personally experienced globalization and what's actually the biggest advantage of it? Thank you.
Globalization is a result of the new developments in technology, the new developments in transfers. It's much easier to travel, it's much easier to move money from one side to another on the planet, it's much easier to organize your company having the head of the company in Germany, the production in China, and the logistics in Greece, and the IT department in India. And that is a result of the progress of the science and of the technology. But the real question is, who is driving, who is controlling that process? And now we do not have rules, global rules, trying to put some limits in that economy, which 10 years ago, with the big crisis of 2008, proved that it works like a casino economy, and we had a big crisis because of that. So I think that for the European Union it is important to see the reality that globalization gives additional opportunities to rising economies in other parts of the planet, but also to try to put global rules accepted from all in the process of the global economy, like we did about the climate change with the Paris Agreement. For that, we have some spaces of dialogue, some institutions like WTO or meetings like G20, in which we are participating as European Union. And on that, there are different financial interests from the different players, and there is a need for a cooperation and for an agreement, a compromise at the end. But I think that we have to avoid two major dangers. One is, in the name of the globalization, to go back in an era of protectionism, building walls between us and the others, because it will damage the economy and there will be a negative effect for the living standards of the people, and mainly of the working people. And from the other side, a second danger is to say that there is no need for rules, there is no need to fix that process. Let's leave the economy freely to do its job, because it will create new bubbles and a new big crisis. We have to work somewhere in the middle, getting all the benefits from the progress of the technology, but trying to put some rules, some limits, because we have to protect also the normal people, who are working people without a lot of money, playing games in the name of the globalization. Isn't so easy, but we have to work on that path. Thank you very much.